Hello, I'm Courtney Wetzup, and welcome to Book Talk. Today I am going to be discussing Furthermore by Tahara Mafi, and this is Tahara Mafi's first standalone novel, and this book was released last August, and I just finished it last night, and I had such a fun time reading this book. It was so nice to be reading a Tahara Mafi book again, because I finally finished the Shatter Me series last summer, and I adored that series, and I was really excited for this book. And this book, it did disappoint me a little. Like, this is very different from Shatter Me, but I still thought this was a cute and fun read, and it was also really quick too, and it was just really cool to see something else from Tahara, because, you know, I love Shatter Me, and it was just cool to get out of the Shatter Me world for once and read this. But I definitely think Shatter Me is better, in my opinion. I have some problems with this book, but I also have a lot of problems with Shatter Me too, but I'll discuss that more later. But if you don't know what this book is about, it's about a girl named Alice, and her father went missing 3 years ago. Not missing, he left 3 years ago, and she's been wondering ever since, where did her father go? And so she goes on this magical adventure with a boy named Oliver to a place called Furthermore, and together they try to find her father, and they get into a bunch of trouble, bunch of bad stuff happens, it's crazy. But it's a super fun, cute little read. I had a really fun time reading this book. I gave it 3.5 stars on Goodreads, and that's all I can say. I can't go any further unless I want spoils, so if you haven't read the book yet and you do not want to be spoiled, I would leave right now, so bye, not spoily people! Okay, so Furthermore, let's talk about characters, because, oh my gosh, Alice is so different from Juliet. I couldn't help but keep comparing this to Shatter Me. I try not to do it, but I kept doing it. And Alice, okay, I like Juliet more, but in some ways I kind of liked Alice more, because Alice, I feel like she didn't doubt herself as much as Juliet, and she's definitely not as crazy as Juliet either, but I still love Juliet though. But Alice was really fun. I thought she was a really cool protagonist, and I thought it was so interesting how in this world everything's colorful. In Fernwood, it's all colorful and everyone has this great talent, but Alice doesn't really have one. She has white hair, she's very pale, like, oh my gosh, now just thinking about it, she's like me, because I'm so pale. But and she also has this talent where she can change colors, which is so cool. And we didn't find that out until later on, which I hated it when the narrator of this book, because I found it really interesting. One of the things I actually really liked about this book was how it's not Alice telling the story, but it's like a completely different person that you never meet. And I loved how the narrator would refer back to us, the readers, and I just found that really interesting. This felt like a fairy tale to me because of that. But back to Alice, she can change colors. So like once she was like changing the colors of a forest and the grass and everything. But I was saying, I hated it when the narrator was like, oh, I can now formally tell you what Alice can do, but you've probably figured it out already. And I was like, no, I haven't. I did not guess that she could do that. But then the narrator told me, and I was like, well, thank you for telling me that now. But I found that really cool. And then we have Oliver, which I loved Oliver the moment we met him. But then he kept, like, just switching sides. And oh my gosh, I loved it but hated it when we visited Time, aka Tim. And Tim's just like, oh yeah, Oliver's been lying to you this whole time. He's never met your dad. He's such a failure. He's been lying to you. Just so you all know. And I kept feeling backstabbed by him. And Alice was like, one moment she was trusting him, the next she wasn't. And then she would like immediately trust him again. I don't know. Maybe it was just because like that's the only other person she knows and she can't survive without him. And I just thought their friendship was really nice. I really liked the bond between the two. And I'm so glad nothing like romantic happened between them, because like, I mean, I would have accepted that, but they're 12-year-olds here, okay? They're not like Juliet age. They're youngins, and they didn't really want them to go down romantic lane, but they did have like some romantic stuff in it, like, and it would be awkward and they would both blush, but nothing happened between the two, which thank goodness, because I didn't want it to go that way. But the adventure in Furthermore was really fun. I thought Furthermore was a really cool world. It kind of reminded me a lot of Wonderland. Okay, this book, I know this book is not Alice in Wonderland, which I think Tara Mafi has said like 5 times, but I couldn't help but keep relating this to Alice in Wonderland. I was like, wow, Furthermore is like a so much more complicated version of Wonderland. And oh my gosh, like the fox in a way was kind of like the Cheshire Cat. Time was like the actual time in Wonderland. I don't know, I was just getting many Wonderland vibes, but I don't really know what my favorite part was in Furthermore, because they kept like almost dying all the time. I was like, okay, these two are 12, how are they surviving? Like, and oh my gosh, I found it so weird how these people in Furthermore want to eat them because they have magic, because in Furthermore they don't have magic, but in Fernwood they do, because there was like that whole war thingamabob, and they want to eat them. And dude, I felt so backstabbed when they were in the Land of Left, which when they got there and that dude Pearman was acting all happy, you know, I was like, oh, you know, he hasn't had a visitor in like 56 years. He's been waiting for this whole life. But still, something kind of felt off, because everything's been off in Furthermore. Everything's been going wrong. And we can't just go to the Land of Left and everything be fine. Like, something was going to happen. And then they wanted to eat them in the Land of Left. And I was like, are you kidding me? Like, this, they kept talking about the feast, and then the feast was actually to eat them, and I was like, boy, are you kidding me? And I almost was fooled that we were gonna be safe there, but we weren't. But then we fell to that place where the Isla girl was, a seamstress. She was pretty dang cool. She was barely there though. That was a little sad. I wanted to see more of her because I thought she was great. And then oh my gosh, walking through the painting, that was like walking through the mirror in Wonderland. I was like, the Wonderland parallels keep coming. But dude, this whole journey to find her father, I honestly thought it was gonna fail most of the time. But then when they walked through that mirror and that guy was there, I immediately knew that was her dad. I don't know how, but I was like, this is probably her dad, because as I kept reading last night, like, there was less pages left, and I was like, okay, this dude isn't her dad, then I'm going to be mad. And then it was, and at first, I was like, okay, how is Alex not recognizing him immediately? But she did say he looked different, like he had longer hair and the beard, and she also looks different too, because she lost an arm. She lost an arm from a paper fox. Reading that scene, oh my gosh, I was mortified by it. But she has one arm, she's pale, she's older, because I mean, last time he saw her, she was 9, so obviously things have changed in the past 3 years. But when they both realized who they were, oh, so nice. And I loved it how she fainted, and the narrator's just like, yeah, she was unconscious for a while. I'm just gonna summarize and whatever happened. And I really wish we got to know who the narrator was, because I would have loved to known that, because it's mentioned throughout the story that the narrator was obviously told this by Alice and Oliver, because he kept saying that, oh, Alice said this when she was telling me the story. And I was like, who are you? Are you someone we know? Are you someone we don't know at all? I just wanted to know. What if it was the dad? If it was the dad, I would. Oh, no. Nope. Never mind. I don't want to know. But I just, oh, the end was so happy. Oh my gosh, when the mom hugged Alice when they came back. Oh, it was so nice. It made me so happy. And this was just a really happy book. I've been just reading sad stuff, and this was just filled with happiness and love, and I loved it. I think that's all I have to say. So thank you all so much for watching this video. And I am Courtney. I'll see y'all next time with a new video soon. So I will see you then. So bye! Yo!